Hey everyone, welcome to Tech Halt. Today we are going to learn stripes pattern. We'll be learning horizontal stripes, vertical stripes and diagonal stripes. And this stripe pattern will be a seamless pattern. So let's begin. Open Illustrator, go to File, New. I've set the width to 1000, height 1000. And color mode is set to RGB and click on OK. We'll take the rectangle tool and we'll draw our first stripe. We don't want the stroke, so we'll click on none, select the fill color. To create a copy, Alt click and drag. This will create one copy of this stripe. But we want this stripe to be placed exactly beneath the first stripe. So what we'll do is, we'll delete this. Again I'll select the first stripe, hold down Alt key, then press Shift, click and drag. So this will place the stripe exactly below the first stripe. Now we'll change the color of this stripe to white. Select both the stripes and you can either go to swatches, select the stripes and directly drag and drop to create a pattern. Another method is select the stripes, go to Object, Pattern, Make. So it will show you a dialog box. New pattern has been added to swatches panel. Any changes made while in the pattern editing mode will be applied to swatch upon exit. Okay, so you can make changes. Suppose you want to change the color of the stripe, you can make the changes and those changes will be applied to the objects where you have applied this pattern. So click on OK. So it will look something like this, and then this is our pattern. We'll click on done. Now next is vertical stripes pattern. So we'll select both the stripes, we'll press Ctrl G to group. Right click, transform, rotate, and on the angle we'll enter 90 degrees. And this is our vertical stripe pattern. Again you can click and drag. Now we can apply these stripes to any object. Simply draw any object and click on the pattern. So this pattern will be applied to the object, or you can click on the pattern first and then select any shape and that pattern will be applied to that shape. Whatever shape you will draw, the pattern will be already applied to it. If you want to change the pattern, select your object, click on another pattern. You can also fill a solid color, so you can change the pattern or swatches. Suppose you want to change the color of the stripe, double click on the swatches, select your stripe. This stripe is white colored, so you can change the color. You can change the color for both the stripes. And then once you finish editing, click on done. So the changes will be saved in the pattern swatch also, and the objects where you have applied that pattern also. Okay, now moving to diagonal stripes. Now for diagonal stripes pattern, you need to take a artboard which is square in shape. It is very important that the artboard should be square in shape, because only then we'll be able to create a seamless pattern. Now we'll take rectangle tool and draw a rectangle. This rectangle should be bigger than the size of your artboard. Now we'll align this rectangle to the artboard. So click here and select this option, align to artboard. Now you need to align horizontal centers and vertical centers. So this is aligned. Now right click, transform, rotate. And then you can rotate this to 45 degrees. Click on OK. This is exactly placed in the center of your artboard. Now go to view, turn on your smart guides and snap to point. Both these options should be selected. Click exactly in the middle of your line, the stroke which you have drawn. Click and drag. Snap it exactly to the corner of your artboard. Now we need one more copy. Alt, click and drag. And again, snap this also properly. Select both the rectangles. Go to blend. Click on one rectangle and then on the other one to give you the stripes pattern. But remember that this should be aligned properly. Both the lines should be aligned exactly to the corners. There is one more method. Select the first rectangle and right click, transform, move. Now here we'll enter the position, that is the size of our artboard. So our artboard was 1000 by 1000, and then we'll click on copy. So this will be placed exactly to the corners of our artboard. Now you can go to blend tool, click and drag. Another method is select both the objects, object, blend, make. So by default we are getting only these three lines, but we want to edit and add even more steps. So we'll go to object, blend options. From here we'll select specified steps, turn on the preview, and you can increase the number of steps. But remember, the number of steps should be odd. It is very important that the number of steps should be odd, because we want one diagonal to pass through the middle of our artboard. So one line should pass through the artboard. And then we'll click on OK. Again, we'll take one more rectangle. And click and release. and the width and height should be same as the size of our artboard. Click on OK. We'll change the color. Align it to the artboard. Now we'll select our blend stripes and go to Object, Expand. Check both the boxes, Object and Fill, and Expand, Ungroup. In case if you have taken line segment instead of rectangle tool, then you will have to expand twice. Once to release the blend mode and another time to convert it from a stroke to a fill. We'll select all the objects. We'll go to Window, Pathfinder, and click on Crop. So once you click on Crop, you will get your transparent diagonal stripes pattern, which is seamless. So you can click and drag and put it in the swatches panel, and then you can take whatever shape you want. And your stripes will be applied to the shape, and this is a seamless pattern. Now suppose if you want to add a background to this stripes pattern, so one option we are going to keep with transparent background, another one we are going to put a background also. So what we'll do is we'll go to rectangle tool again, take a rectangle which is the size of your artboard, click on OK, again align, and you can put any color, right click, arrange, send to back. So this is your stripes pattern having background. Now select both the objects and release it in the swatches panel. Whatever shape you will draw, it will contain this pattern, which is a seamless pattern. Now suppose if you want to change the color later on, suppose if you want to edit the colors, double click on your swatches and select your stripes. Select the background and you can change the background to any other color you want. Also, you can change the color for your stripes. You need to make a group of the stripes. Select all the stripes. Group them, press Ctrl G, and then you can change the color of your stripes and click on Done. So this is your swatch which is edited. Thanks for watching. If you have learned something from our channel, please consider subscribing to our channel and do not forget to like and share our videos. See you in the next video. Till next time, stay safe and stick around.